Good morning, Live Spring. As we prepare to start this morning, some of you that might not have been with us for a while don't know this, but the way we used to celebrate our birthday is we used to chunk around a beach ball. So I hope you don't get hit in the head, but that's what we're going to do today. We are going to play. We are going to celebrate the 13th birthday of Live Spring Church. Everybody, we're so glad that you're here this morning to celebrate Live Spring's 13th birthday. I don't have to stand up. You're all standing up. Let's keep with the clapping and the raising of our hands as we worship our Savior this morning.
Shout out your praise. Oh, oh, we shout out your praise. We sing to the God who heals. We sing to the God who saves. We sing to the God who always makes the way. As he hung upon that cross, then he rose up from that grave. My God's still rolling stones away. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. We'll shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. We'll shout out your praise. We were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're
of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. We'll shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. We're gonna shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord today. We won't be quiet. Shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is surely in this place. We won't be quiet. We'll shout out your praise.
On this journey, I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. And my story isn't over, my story's just begun. Come on. And failure won't define me, that's what my Father does. Sing it out. Failure won't define me, that's what my Father does. Lay your burdens down, ooh. Here in the Father's house, check your shame at the door. It ain't welcome anymore, ooh. Oh. We're in the Father's house, hey. Arrival's not the end game, the journey's where you are. You never wanted perfect, you just wanted my heart. And the story isn't over, if the story isn't good, huh? Your failure's never final when the Father's, come on. Whoa, failure's never final when the Father's in the room. Lay your burdens down, ooh. Here in the Father's house, check your shame out the door. It ain't welcome anymore.
prodigals come home. The helpless find home. Love is on the move. Come on. When the Father's in the room, prison doors free wide.
I hear you.
Come to life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room.
Hey! Miracles take place. The cynical find faith. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Jericho walls are shaking. Strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Breaking through when the Father's in the room. Come on, sing it out. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house. Check your shame out the door. It ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, oh, you're in the Father's house. Ooh, here in the Father's house, check your shame out the door. It ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, oh, you're in the Father's house. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. The wind is watching every gesture of your hand. Waves of fear collapse at your command. I know tomorrow, when the pressure rushes in, you'll be there to rescue me again. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. Here in your presence, there will be no other throne. Oh, my heart is yours and yours alone. The song of heaven and my soul will sing the same. Jesus Christ, the name above all names. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. Glory, glory, and a thousand hallelujahs. Oh Lord my God, how great you.
Come on, sing this out with me.
honor, power, and another hallelujah. Oh, Lord, my God.
He hears you, church. Come on, sing it out.
Glory, glory, and a thousand hallelujahs. Oh, Lord, my God, how great you are. Honor, power, and another hallelujah. Oh, Lord, my God, how great you are. Mighty God, what a mighty God you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God you are.
Come on, let's hear the voices just sing that.
What a mighty God. What a mighty God.
Come on, lift it up.
What a mighty God. What a mighty God you are. What a mighty God. What a mighty God.
There we are.
You are. What a mighty God. What a mighty God you are.
Welcome to Life Spring Church, family.
Amen.
Love you guys. We are over capacity today, and it's a beautiful thing to look at. Man, here. Love it. There are some vacant seats up here, so some folks in the back, well, you're welcome to come in and fill in those empty seats. You don't have to stand back there. You can come in here and fill them in.
Raise your hand if you have an empty seat beside you.
I'm seeing four over here. I'm seeing some over here. We've got some spots, guys. So come in and fill in the pews for me. So Thursday, Rex, you know, when Rex speaks, we like to listen to him. And with me, I think some of his favorite things to say are, Doyle, good on this, but. And I think that was a theme I shared with you last week, is that whole thing. And he said to me, one thing I'd like to see you do differently when you're up there talking is replace the word take and use the word invite. And so I'm thinking about that today with the whole, I want to invite you to come in and enjoy being here with us and having this fellowship time with us. So I'm inviting you. And also, happy 13th birthday, Life Spring Church.
Amen.
Number 13. So I wasn't here at the beginning, but I've been here for at least half that now. We're going on half that. And it's amazing to see this place be finally a teenager. And but hopefully Life Spring Church doesn't suffer the teenage years like I've seen some of my own go through in their teenage years. I got one up there shaking her head at me right now. So let's have that. So we have 13th birthday this week. Next week we're having rally day. So the small groups, we're ready to begin that again. Small groups are going to happen. So we got the men's group is going to be on fire as are the women's group, the Bible studies, the things we've got going on. So that's going to be here next Sunday. And so that invitation is extended to everyone that's here. And then moving on to tithe and offerings. And this is where Rex said, Doyle, would you like it if I came up to you and said, give me, I'm going to take $100 from you. And I said, well, I'll give it to you if you want it. But he said, that's not the point. The point is, I want you to learn to say, I invite you to enjoy the blessings of giving.
Amen.
And sharing in the blessings that God gives us back when we take that time to share in our tithes. And there's story after story of people who have stood up to that call and their lives have been changed as a result of it. So I invite you to participate and to enjoy getting to do that. In fact, I'd like to go ahead and invite my ushers. You're doing that now? So ushers, go ahead and come on up. And I invite you all to join this. So we have a bucket. We can do it online. We have a P.O. Box 886 in Rockwall. There's a QC code, and there's these funny little machine kiosk things in the back that I've never played with, but I'm sure they work just fine. So I wanted to share that with you. And then I'm going to invite two of my favorite people to come up here. You're going to get a lot out of them. Is Brendan and Amy. Come on up. Love you guys.
Morning, church. Happy birthday. Man, we're excited. Man, we're excited. A lot of y'all have been asking for updates, and we wanted to give you one. So, at 8 p.m. on Thursday night, Rex took a spill out of his truck. He struck his head on his fence and could not move any of his four extremities. He was able to talk to me. He was able to tell me where he was, what his name was. Completely mentally sound. We called an ambulance. The ambulance took him to Baylor, Dallas. They had to intubate him en route and ventilate him the whole way there. When he got to the ER, his vitals destabilized. He had received 3 units of blood. He had to go on vasopressors. Had to go on sedation for the intubation, obviously. They stabilized him, got him to CT scan, found he had broken 2 vertebrae, his C3 and C4 vertebrae. He had lacerated his spinal cord completely, and they were going to do emergent surgery to fix his spinal cord displacement. They also found in the CT scan that he had lacerated both of his vertebral arteries in the back here, and one of his carotid arteries. You only have 4 that go to your head. 2 of them are carotid, 2 of them are vertebral. So you only had 1 going to his head. He went to surgery. Surgery went well. The surgeon had nothing but a good report. He did not become responsive for some time after surgery. This led us to believe that something was wrong. They took him to a CAT scan at 3 a.m. They found he had a stroke on his brain stem, which is inoperable and irreversible. On Saturday morning, that's correct. At 10 a.m., we spoke with the doctor. We found all this out. At 10:30, a miracle happened. We were able to communicate with Rex through blinks. We were able to talk with him very briefly, but we were able to talk with him about what's going on. He was able to communicate 3 things to us. 1, he was in excruciating pain. He said, this sucks. He said, this sucks. 2, he had not seen Jesus yet. And 3, he was ready to go be with Jesus. With that in mind, we invited him. We invited family to come speak with him and share stories with him. Pretty sure all of his family got to see him. That's a praise report right there. 4:30 p.m., 16:30 for you military people, we extubated him. at 5, right around 1700, he went on to be with Jesus. Hallelujah, Israel. Hallelujah, Israel. It was a peaceful and wonderful passing. He went out. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Steps up. Can I get an amen? I can firmly tell you, Dad hated boring funerals. He really did. I went to many beautiful funerals with him that were also boring. And he hated them. He didn't like them. He didn't like tears. And he knew how to put the fun in funeral. Amen? So save your tears. Save your tears. Because there's nothing but joy in the house of the Lord. Amen? Amen? Amy's going to share a word with you guys. Because nothing's changing. Nothing's changing.
Thank you all for being here today. As you can imagine, the last 48 hours has been a whirlwind. But God reminded me about 2 o'clock this morning of the scriptures that God gave us before we started last spring church, when we were filled with questions. And so I just want to reconfirm those things to us as a church family and a church body today. In Jeremiah 33:2, it says, "This is what the Lord says. The Lord who made the earth, who formed and established it, whose name is the Lord. Ask me, and I will tell you remarkable secrets you do not know about things to come." God so clearly spoke to Rex and I that he was the one who made LifeSpring Church. He formed it and he established it. And that has not changed. That has not changed. So, Pastor Rex won't be here in physical, but he is still here in spirit. His heart is here, and the vision of this church is strong. The leadership of this church is strong. The church family is strong. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever, and he makes no mistakes. Shared last week that he was so excited because God told him for the first time in 25 years that in 2024 he was to be in full-time ministry. And I'm here to tell you that effective last night at 5 o'clock p.m. he's in full-time ministry. He's in ministry for me, for our kids, for their spouses, for our grandkids and those to come, for all of his siblings, his brother, his sister, his parents, for each and every one of you. He is, I promise you, he's in Jesus' ear. And his relationship with him is stronger than it's ever been. It was strong before, but it's stronger than it's ever been. So, I love you all. Thank you for your prayers. Thank you for your prayers. We will be in touch. We don't meet with the funeral home till Tuesday, so as soon as we know something, we will let everyone know. We appreciate all the phone calls, the texts, the messages. I can't even respond to them all. Y'all are just simply amazing. So, thank you very much.
At this time, we'd like to invite Robert on up here. He's going to share a wonderful message today. It's going to really touch your hearts, you guys.
I can't believe all y'all showed up to hear me preach. Pack the house. Bam, Rex, I got you. I got you. I packed the house. We want to celebrate, Rex. Yes. This isn't time for sadness. It's not about him. This is LifeSpring's birthday. We're celebrating LifeSpring's birthday. He planted this church, and we're going to continue this church, okay? I would like, actually, before I even get into my message right now, I want staff to come up and stand with me. This is your staff of Life Spring Church. We will continue to be your staff at Life Spring Church. We will continue to serve you in every way, shape, or form that Rex and Amy did. We will continue to be a blessing to you. We will continue to open these doors. They will not be closed. Rex's greatest regret was closing the doors during COVID, and he said it would never happen again. And as me, as I'm interim pastor or lead pastor right now, it will not close. Doors will be open. Amen. If you need to reach out to any one of us, we are open. We have our phones on. Please reach out to us. If you don't have our phone numbers, we will have our phone numbers given to you. Please, please, please reach out to us. This is what we are made for at such a time as this. God bless you. We're gonna watch a video. If you want to go back, we're gonna watch a video of some pictures of Life Spring Church over the last 13 years. You get to see me when I was a little bit skinnier. You get to see all of us when we were probably a little bit skinnier. But we're going to play some pictures. I'll tell you, talk you through. This is Nebby Williams. This is, I know. I think that's Shirley right there. No, maybe. I don't know. It's Shirley. Shirley's back there. This was our some prayer meetings at Rex and Amy's house before we even started. Before we even started, we had prayer meetings at their house. Coffee, cake, and call on God meetings. And that's what we did. We sat down, Rex set out our vision and said, this is what we're going to do and this is how we're going to do it. And from day one, we backed him in every way possible. Welcome. There we go. He looks a little stretched out right there. I don't know. Nebby Williams again, our sanctuary. Every week we set up and broke down. We had a trailer full of all this stuff. And every one of that stuff went into that trailer. All those chairs and everything. Dennis did our Christmas play. There you go. There you go. Giving the word, continuing to give the word. It will continue. Look at those little kids. Oh, the Christmas parties. Rex's book. You can still get that Rex's book, so it will continue to go on. This is actually a crazy... We helped a couple redo this house, and I got poison ivy from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet. And then I passed it on to my wife. Look at them guns. You see that? Bam! That was the youth camp. We had 20-something kids at youth camp. It was amazing. Here's the men's group. We're commissioning men there. We continue to do that in the men's group as Doyle will continue to lead that. Amy giving one of her Mother's Day messages. Put on your big girl panties or your big boy boxers. Continue at Nebby Williams. There's Life Spring Drive. It is still Life Spring Drive. It will continue forever to be Life Spring Drive. And we will continue to have the goal to have a church on Life Spring Drive. That hasn't changed. And it won't change. And there's Roy as Chewbacca. Continuing ministry. We will continue that ministry forever. More of the home church. We used to meet at their homes on Monday nights because we didn't have a sanctuary. So we'd have men's group and women's groups in the same house. More youth group pictures from youth camp. We outgrew the auditorium. We moved into the gym. Amy's Christmas party. We're singing YMCA. I was trying to. That's the photo stretched out, I promise you. It's and that's here. that's getting this place ready for us. Glenn's still back there, same spot. So's Ricky, so's Lisa. Glenn and Vicky. And Glenn again. The closing on this property. We have Fava. That's our lobby. Wow. We're praying over this house right now. That's what it used to be, right there. Just a warehouse. Yep. Sound booth. It's the stage. Continue, Fava. Kay and Shirley, another Christmas party. There's Brennan. That was a Halloween outreach. Yep, we had it inside because it was raining. That's me, the dinosaur back there. Easter egg. There we go. Easter egg hunt. Amy preaching again. Whoa! That picture is not stretched out. Brendan is that big. Oh. Another ministry where we helped out rebuilding someone's house. We still continue to do outreaches. That will not stop. We will do outreaches at this church. We'll continue to do that. Oh, look at that one. That one's elongated. That picture's elongated, not. The baptism. Oh God. Easter. Awesome. Halloween. Christmas Eve service, candlelight services. Is that Doyle? Oh. This was our praise. We had a praise night where we just set up and praised Jesus during COVID so that anyone could come. And if you're not here, it's at 9:30 every Sunday morning. We will continue to have that prayer service in that circle, in that lobby. I challenge you to be here early, where we have to move it from the lobby to in here. And we'll make a circle in here, and we'll pray. Wow, that's a lot of cupcakes. Another outreach. Danny looks a little stretched, too, right there. Oh, that's Daryl under that. Yeah. The lovely ladies of Life Spring. This was our Christmas staff party. We all went on a carriage ride around Highland Park. Brennan hated it because he hates horses. That's our playground. It finally got installed. It was donated to us. Thanksgiving, Friendsgiving. So this is part of our ministry. We'll continue as our ministry, as the couples group. Doyle being commissioned right there. Wonderful kids. And Life Spring staff, this was at Celebrate Faith. Backpack giveaways for school. Merv, The Rock. Baptism. Prayer. So that was at dinner. After setup, we would go have dinner afterwards. So we worked for food during those days. That's how Rex paid his staff. We would come up here, set up, and then he would feed us. I was talking to Vicky this morning about that and missing, not missing the setup, but missing those fellowship times of going. And Rex told me, he said, "You're going to miss these moments." And I was like, "You're crazy. There is no way I'm going to miss busting my butt to get up here, to grab a trailer, to pull up here, to unload everything, and to go out to eat." But he was right. We miss those times. We miss those times. But it's not a goodbye. It's a see you later. It's a see you later. So in 2 Samuel 12, 15 through 23, this is a story of David. David had a child that got sick. And for 7 days, David prayed. David fasted. David locked himself in a room. He wouldn't bathe. He wouldn't see anybody. He just lost himself. So we can go ahead and read it. I guess I'll go ahead and read. Then Nathan departed to the house. Let's see. Let's go this way. I can't see that far. David therefore pleaded with God for the child, and David fasted and went and laid all night on the ground. So the elders of the house arose and went to him to raise him up from the ground, but he would not, nor did he eat food with them. Then on the seventh day it came to pass that the child died, and the servants of David were afraid to tell him that the child was dead. For they said, "Indeed, while the child was alive, we spoke to him, and he would not heed our voice. How can we tell him that the child is dead? He may do some harm." But what did David do? When David saw that his servants were whispering, David perceived that the child was dead. Therefore David said to his servants, "Is the child dead?" They said, "Yes, he is dead." So David arose from the ground. He washed and anointed himself, changed his clothes, and he went into the house of the Lord and worshiped.
Amen.
He went into the house and worshiped. He praised the Lord. Then he went to his home, to his own house, and when he requested that he set food before him, and he ate. Then his servant said to him, "What is this that you have done? You fasted and wept for the child while he was alive, but when the child died, you arose and ate food." And he said, "While the child was alive, I fasted and wept. I said, who can tell whether the Lord will be gracious to me that the child may live? But now he is dead. Why should I fast? I can bring him back. Can I bring him back? I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me. I shall go to him, but he will not return to me." He knew that it was no longer the time for the prayer. He had passed. He was in heaven. That child was in heaven. It was a time to celebrate, to worship God, and to move on. And I don't mean that in any way, shape, or form, but it's time to step into the next worship time and the next fellowship time. To remember Rex and know that we're going to see him again one day. We know. He said, what did David say? "I'm going to go see him. I will go see him one day. I will go see Rex one day." Amen?
Amen.
Amen. In 1 Thessalonians 4:13. "But I do not want to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. For I believe that Jesus died and rose again. Even so, God will bring him those who sleep in Jesus." We're not sorrowful like we're not going to see him again. We don't wail and weep like we're never going to be there again. It's just to see you later. You know, we hug someone when they're going on vacation. When we see them off on the airport at an airplane, we hug them goodbye. We say our goodbyes. We tell them we love them, and then they're gone because we know we're going to see them again. We're going to see them again, and I have no faith, no doubt in that, no doubt. Amen, amen. So, we're going to continue to have LifeSpring Church. We're going to continue to be LifeSpring Church. We always talked as we're a family. We are still a family. We love every one of you. And we thank you so much for all the text messages and all of everything. I know it's been kind of weird and crazy these last couple days, but we're here for you. We love you. We want to do life, continue to do life with you. You are our family. When the scripture, when we got the call at 3:15 Friday morning, we immediately jumped up and we headed to the hospital. And before we even got there, a scripture kept playing in my head and playing in my head and playing in my head. It says that we were built for such a time as this. And it just, I had no idea how any of this was going, what it going to go. But it was like, okay, this is your time. And I was like, no, God, no. I'm nobody. I'm just some Joe Schmo that's been protected and been covered by Rex. And so I'm not ready for this. He said, you were built for such a time as this. And so it's in the story of Esther. And we're going to kind of just give an overview of Esther. My wife, I love my wife. And she is actually, she has her bachelor's degree in biblical studies. And so now she's like, well, that's not really kind of how it means. And she gave me this whole deal about Esther. Well, there's so much more about Esther. And I was like, you know, I've read the book of Esther and I've done it. And so I'm going to kind of give you an overview of it. If she wants to come up and give anything, guess not. I had to try. But so with Esther, she was an orphan, and her cousin or uncle, cousin Mordecai raised her and just raised her up. And King Xerxes, if you ever seen the movie 300, the king that was at Persia was King Xerxes. So this is truth. You know, the movies portray him as this crazy mean king, and he probably could have been. He was. And so there you go, from my biblical scholar. There you go. he was having a big banquet, and his wife wouldn't go into the room with him because he was going to parade his wife. Hey, look at this beautiful wife that I have, da da da. Well, she said no. And that single no changed the fate of the Jewish people completely. This one no that she said, that God put in her mouth, changed the lives of billions of people. This moment, my wife said, you know, she's been hurt all of her life, and a couple people have said, one phone call changes the rest of your life. One phone call. That no changed the lives of billions of people. So she said, no, I'm not going to do that. And so he was like, you're my wife. You're going to do this. And she said, no again. And he said, goodbye. And he like kicked her out. And he said, okay, well, I need another wife. So he basically put on a Persian Miss America contest. A Miss Persia contest, we'll call it. So he sent out a bunch of people. They came back with a bunch of beautiful women. And they prepped them and did all this. And he picked Esther as the most beautiful woman in all the land, and became his wife. So going forward into that, there was a man named Hamish, and thank you. y'all got me. Y'all cover me. Absolutely. So Haman, and he wanted to kill all the Jews, and he got the king to sign a decree that said it's okay to kill the Jews. And they built these big towers, these gallows, to hang the Jews right in the middle of the town. And they got word of it, and Mordecai, her uncle, her cousin, came to her and said, hey, we need you to go to the king and tell him that this is going on, that this, your people are going to be slaughtered. And she said, okay, but I can't go to the king. I can't go to the king without being requested. And so she said, but pray and fast. Tell everyone there for 3 days to pray and fast. And so for 3 days, they prayed and fasted. If she went to the king without being summoned, she could be beheaded. She put her life on the line for her people. She said, okay, this is what has to be done. I'm going to lay my life down for my friends and my family. And so she came and she prayed, and she, to make it a little bit shorter, she proceeded to give him a banquet and feed him and stuff. And she didn't ask anything the first time. She came back, she gave him another banquet, and then I think a third one before she actually gave his request. How many of you had your kids or somebody come home, you come home and the house is a little clean, you're like, what do you want? What are you trying to get? What are you trying to get? You know, they cleaned up, they vacuumed, they come in and they show you. Oh, look, I'm vacuuming. Yeah. Okay, what do you want? That's what she did. Three times she did this banquet because she wanted to give him a request. And she finally gave him the request and found out that what was going on. And there's a whole backstory to this. But she was put in that time for such a time as this. She was made bold in her faith in her community for such a time as this. Her orphanage, her being orphaned as a child, her being brought up by her cousin in that community for such a time as this. She had to go boldly before the king, boldly, and stand there and stand and speak the words, knowing that she could be killed for the words she spoke. How many of you have had to be that bold and say, Jesus, knowing that you could be killed? That's the boldness that Rex talked about last week. It's the boldness that we got to have going forward. Rex isn't here to protect us anymore, but our staff is here. I'm here. And we're going to continue to be bold in our faith. And we were built for such a time as this. A little bit of my backstory that got me here. As a kid, I was raised in church. I knew God at an early age. I found Jesus at an early age. I fell away. I found drugs. And even in my years of drug addiction, even in my lowest of lows, I knew that there was a God. I couldn't explain it. I couldn't understand it, but I knew there was a God. And I can tell you the loneliest moment I ever had in my life, and it was for a couple of years. As I was doing drugs one night, I knew that God, I don't know whether God's presence left me or God left me inside, but I know that I felt God step away and say, I'm sorry, I can't be here in this life. And it was the loneliest feeling I've ever had in my life. And I filled that loneliness with drugs and with alcohol, with everything else. But thank God that I found the love of a woman. I quit doing drugs. I got clean. I found my wonderful wife, who is a whole nother testimony of how she prayed for me for years. For years she prayed for me, not knowing it was me. She was praying for a husband, a leader. And what she got was a drunk. Because I was an alcoholic when we first met. I was drinking all the time. But God told her, no, that's him. She's like, no. I prayed for a godly man. I prayed for a godly leader. I prayed for someone to love my kids. That's him. She's like, no. That's Robert. I know him from high school. We dated in junior high. We dated in high school. That's not the man. Oh, yeah. God got you. So, I found the love of a woman, and it changed my life. And then I found the love of Jesus again. And Jesus saved me and changed my life. And in that moment, when I was back in church, and I was so hungry for the word, I found Rex. I found Rex. And he fed into me so much. I used to get up early and go to prayer meetings just to be in his presence with Rex and be in those prayer meetings. I sought his wisdom. I would, before my wife was a Bible scholar, I would come to her. I would like open up the scriptures, like, wait, what about this? Can you tell me this? Can you answer? She's like, no, go ask Rex. Okay, here we go. And I would go ask Rex. And I would bombard him at 6:30 in the morning and say, hey, what about this? You know, I was so hungry for it. And he fed into me. And then whenever they came to us, they handed us a letter at Sunday morning service, said, hey, we want to meet with y'all. And it changed our lives. Forever. That letter changed the lives of everyone in here. You didn't know it. They did. And that letter told us, hey, we're having a coffee, cake, and call on God meetings. And Rex set out his vision with us, with Amy, with many of you that are still here today. 14 years ago. We started, a year and a half before we ever even launched. A year and a half. So really, we're 14 and a half years old. Just our launch day is 13 years ago. But Danny and Shirley and Kay and Dennis, y'all were all there. And we continued. Nelson and Lisa, back there. God, I love you guys. And they continue to do that. And we have staff meetings about once a month, maybe once every couple of months. We had them every week that year. And we lived in Garland, so we were driving over here to Rockwall every day, every Monday night, Sunday, Monday. Our staff meetings were the reason we moved to Rockwall, because we were like, we're tired of driving all the way over here every time. So we moved to Rockwall. But he was feeding into us. Rex, every time, every week he had a word for us. Every week he would say, here, this is what we're learning, this is what we need to do, this is the path we're going. And he would set it out and he would plan it out, and it was so structured. And I thank God that he put that into my life, that I could be in this place that I am today, built for such a time as this. Built for such a time as this. So we're going to continue to do that. I want all the staff to come back up. I want y'all to pray for the family. I want y'all to pray for staff. You have a word, Brent? Brent, come on. Come on up. You're staff too, Brent. Come on. I want you guys to pray for us. Y'all can stand. We're gonna play some praise and worship music. If y'all want to come up here and lay hands on us, y'all can lay hands on us. Y'all want to hug our necks, please come hug our necks. We love you and we are here for you. We will continue to be here for you for the rest of our days. Amen. Amen. I love you guys. Thank y'all so much. Oh, there's cards in the back. If y'all want to write whatever you want to write, stories, tell stories, write on it. If you want to give to the family, if you want to give anything, please, no food. No food right now. Y'all can give on the Benevolence Fund. If you go on our website, click on Benevolence and write to Rex and Amy, it'll go directly to them. Okay? Cash or gift cards can be put on the table back there. They don't want any food or anything. It'll just go to waste. Amy's had a water and a cracker in the last 48 hours. So she's not hungry right now. So please come forward. We want to just love you and be here for you. Love you guys.
Church.
Yes, you have, Lord, all my life.
goodness of God.
Guys, keep going. We're gonna end with a celebration song. So, you guys sing with us, and let's celebrate. Father's House, number 2. You can stay as long as you need to stay.
Sometimes on this journey, get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. My story isn't over, my story's just begun. Failure won't define me, that's what my Father does. No, failure won't define me, that's what my Father does. Your burdens down, ooh. Here in the Father's house, check your shame at the door. It ain't welcome anymore, ooh. Oh, we're in the Father's house,
was not the end game, the journey's where you are. You never wanted perfect, you just wanted my heart. And the story isn't over, if the story isn't good. No, failures never find a way in the Father's heaven. Sing it out.
Oh, failures never find who when the Father's in the room. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house, check your shame out the door. It ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, oh, we're in the Father's house. Hey. But it's where we need to hear some voices. This is our story. Prodigals come home. The help is final. Love is on the move. When the Father's in the room, prison doors fling wide, the dead come to life. Love is on the move when the Father's in the room. Hey, hey, miracles take place, the cynical find faith. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Here it is. Jericho walls are quaking, strongholds now are shaking. Love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Oh, love is breaking through when the Father's in the room. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house, check your shame out the door. It ain't welcome anymore. Ooh, oh, you're in the Father's house. Ooh, lay your burdens down. Ooh, here in the Father's house, check your shame at the door. It ain't welcome anymore.
We're going to put some music on in the background and just we're just going to let it play. You guys feel free to stay as long as you need to. Say everything you need to say. Thank you.